Welcome to Music City Kids. My name is Tamara with Love in a Big World, and I'm glad you're here. We want to help you grow strong in mind, body, and heart. And one of the things that our team has been talking about is how we are all battling isolation, just being alone because of this pandemic, and we're going on a year now. So how can we build community in the midst of this pandemic? I know people have some really creative ways that they're doing this on social media and Zoom and all that, but is it working for you? I don't know. Some days it works for me and some days it doesn't. I just want to see people in the flesh. I want to hug someone. So today we're going to be diving into this topic about how we can battle isolation and build community. First up, we've got some kids all the way from Chicago with EduMotion who are gonna teach us how to swing dance. It's one of my favorite things to do, no joke. So get up and get ready to learn something new and get moving.
Hello, we are the Dancing with Class All-Stars from Chicago, Illinois. I'm their teacher, Mr. VH. We're normally a group of about 30 people from 4th through 9th grade who love to dance together. But since we can't meet up during COVID-19, we have four of our incredible All-Stars coming at you to teach you a swing line dance that you can do at home. So let's meet our All-Stars quickly. We have Sun.
Hi, my name is Son, and I like music and dancing.
We have Vashti.
Hi, my name is Vashti. I like dancing and drawing. And I think dance is fun and very therapeutic, especially in negative times like COVID-19.
I agree. We have Patricia.
Hi, my name is Patricia, and I love dancing because it gets you the exercise that you need.
And we have Wayne.
Hi, my name is Wayne. I really like dance because it's fun, and I feel like it allows you to express yourself.
Ooh. Hey, Wayne, what have you been doing since you've been at home?
Recently, during quarantine, I started baking a lot.
Right. How about you, Patricia?
I've started to craft a lot.
Ooh. Vashti?
I started drawing more.
Oh. And Son?
I started playing piano more.
That's cool. I started actually playing clarinet, too. So, yeah, bringing more music and dance out there. All right. So we're going to learn a line dance based off of swing dancing. Now, swing dancing started during the Jazz Age in Harlem, New York. It's a really fun and upbeat dance. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to the All-Stars to teach you our steps for our line dance, starting with Sun.
So the first step for the line dance is the basic things and it's called a rock stop step, and you take your right foot and you rock backwards, then you sway to the side and then jump, and then you do that again, and then you add a jump at the end.
All right, Vashti, can you show us the next step? Thanks, Son.
This step is called the grapevine. So you take your right leg, step to the side, then take your left, go back, then go to the side again. Then you're gonna do a kick at the end. And then you're gonna do the same with your left. So side, back, side, kick.
Thanks, Vashti. All right, Patricia, can you show us the next step?
So the next step of the dance is a kick. So what you want to do is you want to take your left leg and you want to kick out. And as you're kicking out, you want to take your hands and push them and like push them out like you're cheering for a team. Then do a forward and back. Then do the same for your right leg. Kick it out and push your hands to the right. Then do another forward and back.
Awesome. Thanks, Patricia. And then Wayne, can you bring us home with the last step?
For the final step, you're going to do 4 kicks while in place and make sure the kicks are in front of you. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you're going to do the Shorty George. That's when you fall into your knee and then you fall to the other side. And you're going to keep doing that until you come back in a circle. That's it. Now you've learned the dance.
Thanks, Wade. That was awesome, guys. All right, so now let's try this dance with some music. All right, get ready. Get your smiling faces on. Make sure you got some space, because we are going to bring in the music for our swing dance routine. Awesome job, guys. All right, we are the Dancing with the Class All-Stars from Chicago, Illinois. Thank you so much, MusiCity Kids, for having us. Bye, everybody.
Thanks, EduMotion. That was awesome. So I will say that one of the things that's pretty cool about the way that we've all leaned into technology during the pandemic is that I've been able to connect with people all over the world. And that group was just from Chicago, and next up is a friend of mine from South Africa. Here's Mr. Steve.
Hello, friends, and welcome to a brand new series of Brain Teasers. This is my chance to get you to exercise the gray matter between your ears. Here comes your first one. Three friends decide to take a road trip. They travel to a town in the middle of nowhere, and they come across a small hotel. The hotel owner says, "Listen here, it's going to cost you $10 each per night if you are sharing a room." $10 each? That seems pretty reasonable. That's no problem. And they each pull out a $10 bill and they hand it over to the hotel owner. Three $10 bills, that makes $30. But then, of course, one of the gentlemen noticed there's a sign on the wall, and the sign says, "Today is Wacky Wednesday," which means it's only $25 for the room. Well, $25 for the room, and they were paying $30. They go to the hotel owner and they say, "But today is Wacky Wednesday." And he goes, "You're absolutely right." And he hands them 5 $1 bills. So they've given each 10, that makes $30. He gives them $5 back. They take the $5 and each of them takes $1. But now there's $2 left over. They give that as a tip to the guy that is helping carry their luggage up to their room. So let me just see if we've got this right. Three people each give $10. They each then get $1 back. Do you agree that means they each paid $9? 9 plus 9 plus 9 is 27. And then, of course, there were $2 that they gave for the tip. 27 and 2 makes 29. Where is my missing dollar? Try to work it out, and I'll be back in a bit with the solution.
So that was part one of the Brain Teaser. Do you think you can figure it out? You can be working on that before we see Mr. Steve again in just a little bit. Next, we've got By Kids for Kids with Sophia. And she's got an amazing idea for a project that you can do with your family right there at home.
My name is Sophia, and today we'll be making origami. Origami is the Japanese word for folding paper, and I'll be showing you how to fold a paper crane. There's an old Japanese legend that says if you fold 1,000 paper cranes, you can make a wish and it'll come true. So let's get started. First, take a square piece of paper, fold it in half, crease it, unfold, then do the same thing to the other side. Once you're done, fold it diagonally now, crease it, unfold, then do the same thing to the other side. Now, your piece of paper should look a little like a tent. Now, take these perpendicular lines, fold inward, and now you should have a square shape. Take one of the corners of the square that we now have, fold inwards, crease, and it should look like this. Do the same thing to the rest of this side and the other side so that your paper looks like a kite. Now, unfold these creases that we just made and take this piece right here, pull it up. So now we have a pocket. Use the creases that we just made, fold inwards, fold down, then up to create a bigger diamond. Do the same thing to the other side and your paper should look like this. These pieces right here will be our wings, but first we have to make the legs and the head. First, flatten this out, fold in this piece of paper at an angle so that it looks like this. Do the same thing to the other side, but this time we're going to take this top piece using the same technique, fold in, crease, and we have our head. One final touch, curl the wings so that they're in a flying position, and hold the crane at the base of the neck, pull the tail, and now it can fly. Thank you.
Thanks, Sophia. You know, another thing that can bring us all together is music. Have you ever heard a song and thought about the people that you were with when you last heard that song? Or remembered a time when you were together singing it? Whether it was around a campfire or in the car, or maybe even at a concert? Remember when we could do that? Well, here's a song that all of us here on Music City Kids can share together. It's from a friend of mine, Damien Horne.
Of those things, some days you got it, but hey, hey, it's only because somebody taught it. See, how can we learn the lesson of love if we choose to hide in the dark? Shine so everybody can shine too. Yeah. Open your heart and lead the way. You don't have to be afraid. It's in you, it's in you to rise high above and greatest fears. Yeah. And with a little bit of light, you can make it right here. Oh, 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 oh. So everybody shine, shine on, everybody shine, shine on, everybody shine. Grace, we could use a little grace, sisters and brothers. And it's a shame, oh what a shame, when we do not give it to one another. See, how can we learn the lesson of love if we choose to hide in the dark? Shine, so everybody can shine too, yeah. Open your heart and to be afraid, it's in you to rise high above your greatest fears. shine, shine on, shine on. Everybody shine, shine on, shine on. Everybody shine. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, 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 oh. See, how can we learn the lesson of love if we choose to hide in the dark? Shine, so everybody can shine too, yeah. Open your heart and lead the way. You don't have to be afraid. It's in you, it's in you. So shine on, shine on, shine on. Everybody shine, shine on, shine on. Everybody shine.
So I've been thinking, how can we battle isolation and bring people together? Well, we've got to let people know that we care. And caring is taking the time to let others know they're important, showing concern for the well-being of others. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that I've been thinking about is how we need role models or examples, heroes, of how to do this really well. Because caring is something that we can talk about, we can know about, but it's another thing to put it into action. So check out this story about Wangari Maathai. She's a woman who planted millions of trees in Africa. And this particular version of the story is told by Franck Prevo. So after receiving her education here in America, Wangari returned to Kenya to start the Greenbelt Movement, which trees that have been cut down and providing jobs for village people. So that's a movement where when the trees were cut down, they replanted the trees, it provided jobs for the village women. So, how does Wangari show that she cares for the trees and the animals? Think about that as you read the story. And how does she show that she cares for the women, their families, the villages? And what can you do to show that you care for nature? We're hearing a lot of talk about climate change, so what can you do every day to show that you care for nature? And what can you do every day that you show you care for people? It's caring that helps us build community. Think about that. Next up, we've got a special message from Dr. Don about anxiety. Here's the deal. Anxiety is when we worry or get afraid of things, and it does strange things to our bodies. I should know. I've dealt with it. Since I was a kid, really. And we find ways to cope, right? But we've also got to realize that what we eat and the vitamins we take, all of that impacts our bodies and how we feel too. So Dr. Dawn's gonna share all those tips with us, because being alone, isolated, can increase our anxiety. That's why we need to figure out how to get connected. Take a listen.
Hey, Music City kids, Dr. Don here with my friend Chuck, and we're here for part two of what we talked about last time with anxiety. So to recap, last time we talked about how the sympathetic nervous system takes over, and the offenders for that were energy drinks and a lot of sugar. So we wanted to get those out of the diet very slowly but surely. Now, there are other things that can help our brain function properly, and these are vitamins and minerals, and they can come from our food. So when we take out those other stuff, other bad stuff, we want to put good stuff in. So there's a mineral called magnesium. Now, even our government says that 40% of the country does not get enough magnesium in their diet. So they're not getting the recommended daily allowance for magnesium, not from their food, not from supplements, not from anything. So we want to make sure, and magnesium will calm the nervous system. So we talked about how the nervous system gets hyped up. Magnesium calms the nervous system, and it works very, very well. But where does it come from? It comes from leafy green vegetables. And if you don't like them, get used to them, because that green has magnesium all in it on the chemical level. So things like spinach, asparagus, and avocados. You know, avocados have a lot of magnesium, and they got a lot of potassium too, but don't tell the bananas. But they're actually a better source of potassium than the bananas are. So we get these minerals from the vegetables. Well, we're also wanting to look at other things like folate. And folate is a specific B vitamin, but they also come from the leafy green vegetables. So remember those. Now, there's other B vitamins that we don't get from leafy greens, like B12. Now, those will come specifically from animal meats. And we like to get good quality, conservatively harvested, but things like salmon, chicken, and beef, those will get a lot of other B vitamins besides B12. They also get B3 and B6. So a lot of different B vitamins, and those B vitamins help your brain start get the gears turned properly. Help slow them down when they need slowing down, and help speed them up when they need speeding up. Keeps you on an even keel. So, super simple. Eat your veggies, people. And drink your water. Stay away from sugar. You can do this. It's not rocket science. It's really not. But magnesium, B vitamins, and stay away from sugar. Leafy greens, avocados, salmon, chicken, beef, good quality. And again, I can't express it enough. Get rid of the sugar and the energy drinks. And these are really easy steps to take that would help you feel better and breathe. That's the last step. Good learning to do big breaths. And Miss Ricky has been talking a lot about how to breathe. That is a huge, huge factor for anxiety. So I hope you got some good tips out of this. And we'll talk to you guys next time. Back to you, Tamara.
Did you get that puzzle figured out? Well, here's the solution.
So this particular one is a classic, but it involves false mathematics. You see, let's do it a different way. Each person paid $9. 9 and 9 and 9 makes 27. That is correct. But then you have to take off the $2 which went for the tip, and that makes 25. And that is exactly how much money they got back. But when you add the $2 on, then you get this number of 29. And then, of course, when people ask where is the missing dollar, people start wondering, hold on, maybe someone took an extra dollar. Maybe a dollar got lost. But the mathematics is that you're supposed to take the $2 off, not add the $2 back on. I hope you like that. There'll be lots more coming in the next edition.
Thanks, Steve. All right, next we've got some spoken word. Take a listen.
Encouraging words that reach ears and soothe souls, flashing your 100-watt smile to brighten days when the sun has taken a sabbatical, offering water to quench desire's thirst, dignity, compassion, support, concern, handshakes and well wishes, hugs and kisses, extending love with no conditions, on a mission to spread joy and lift hearts, offering the best parts of yourself, expressing the full humanity that resides in us all.
Hi friends. So this is my dog Ernie that I was telling you about. He came home during quarantine and he's been such good company to me and my kids. We love him a lot. I'm gonna let him down. So we've been talking today about ways that we can battle isolation and build community. Having a pet is one. Another is finding things that we can do with groups of people, like the dancing that our friends from Chicago showed us at the beginning. We can do that either in person, socially distanced, or via Zoom. We did that today. Let's see. We can find a cause that we care about, like Wangari Maathai, and work together with others to make a difference in our world, caring for nature, caring for one another. We can take the time that we need just to let people know that we're here. As difficult as it is from far away, but we can write letters, we can have phone calls, FaceTime, play dates, even socially distanced or online. I've heard about those too. We've got to find ways that we can connect. And remember too, that this will pass. We're seeing the light at the end of the tunnel now that vaccinations are in process, and we'll be able to gather together again. But in the meantime, we're in this together. We're not alone. So when you're feeling lonely, sad, angry, frustrated, please let somebody you know how you're feeling. Whether it's a parent, a grandparent, an auntie, uncle, cousin, friend, teacher, there are people in your world who care about your well-being. So let them know how you're feeling. And I'm sure that they will give you the time and attention you need to make it through that dark time. And you can always reach out to us here at Music City Kids. My email is tamara@loveinabigworld.org. And my friends and I are believing in you. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time here on Music City Kids.